Hello, I'm Andy Simon. I'm the systems engineer for our Acumen product family, and today we're going to talk about auto-tuning on our Acumen 3 axial torsional system. On the top here we have our axial torsional actuator, actuating both axes from the same side. On the bottom we have our axial torsional force transducer, and here in the middle we have a 3D printed axial torsional sample, two different sizes to demonstrate auto-tuning. So here we have our user interface for our axial torsional Acumen system. You can see the situational awareness diagrams for both axes. We have already completed the system setup steps to get to the point of performing the auto-tuning. You can see here we have our tune for specimen window where we are going to create a new tuning set and we are going to have the system tune itself. We'll start with the torsion axis with the system identifying the specimen characteristics. The Acumen Autotuner functions by measuring all the specimen characteristics, stiffness, mass, and damping, to identify the appropriate tuning set. It does this by the user entering the maximum allowable force values, force or torque values, into the fields here and starting the procedure. You'll see the system ramps to the mean of these two force or torque values and then begins to cycle with a random noise pattern. This random noise pattern will automatically ramp up to never exceed the force or torque entered by the user, and this will be used to identify the characteristics of the sample. As the procedure completes, you will see that the software reports the angular stiffness, mass, and damping of the specimen as it measured them. We then click Apply, which creates the tuning values and enters them into the control system. From here we have a couple options. We can click the Done button, which allows us to save our tuning set and move on to the next step. Or you can choose to go to our Verify step, which will actually measure the performance of the tuning that was just created. You can see the options are very similar, but we have an additional option where we choose which control mode we are actually going to tune. The previous step was performed in the always stable control mode, and now we are going to verify the values actually created for the tuned control mode. So here I will use the same torque values and start the procedure. The procedure looks very similar, but you will note that it is now running in the torque control mode, not the stable angle control mode. When the procedure completes, it will report the measured performance of the control mode in a range of blue, green, red. Green indicating a good and stable control mode, blue indicating a control mode that is on the cold side, or the tuning being too low, red indicating the tuning on the hot or too high of tuning. From here, you can simply drag the slider down into the range and re-perform the tuning step, the verify step, in order to make an adjustment to tuning and then re-evaluate the performance and stability of that tuning set. Once the verification step is complete, there are multiple options. One option is again to click Done in order to save the tuning set and move on, or we can click Back and perform the auto-tuning on the axial axis. So you can see I now selected the axial channel. I select my test type. In this case, it will be tension compression because my sample is rigidly coupled into my test machine. And I enter my minimum and maximum tension and compression values. You can see I enter the values of 75 newtons tension and negative 75 newtons compression. These do not need to be symmetrical, but I chose to make them here. I'll start the procedure to create the axial tuning set. You can see the procedure executes for axial the exact same way as it did for torsion. I'll apply these tuning parameters, and now again I have multiple options. I can verify, I can be done and save my tuning set, or I can go back for a few additional options. I can go into our adjust procedure, which allows me to generate a sine wave or other waveform of choice and make simple gain adjustments with the slider bar. This is a simple adjustment allowing the user to adjust the values from the auto-tuner. This is typically only needed for samples that have very drastically changing characteristics as they are cycled. But it is a nice feature to have. Beyond that, you can go to the Advanced tab, which allows complete access to the complete tuning values, PID, proportional, integral, and derivative gains for the system. The Acumen Autotuner was designed to be a very simple, easy to use autotuner that generates very good results, but also maintain the power and the flexibility that MTS is known for. So you can auto-tune your sample, and in most cases that is as far as you need to go, one step, but you do have the options to do additional adjustment as necessary. So you have seen the auto-tuning procedure on this long sample for axial and torsional axis. The Acumen system and its auto-tuning is designed to function the exact same way for virtually any sample. This is very important for customers who test a wide variety of specimens and want to do it very quickly. So now we have installed our new sample. Simply create a new tuning set, auto-tune. We can change these numbers if we so choose. Enable our actuator and start the procedure. So you have seen how easy it is to tune multiple samples on the Acumen system with our auto-tuner. The focus while developing our auto-tuner was to make it simple, easy to use, and develop reliable and high-performing tuning, all while not compromising the flexibility and power to tune the most difficult samples and test them on the MTS system. For both the experienced test engineer and the occasional user, the MTS Acumen Autotune is both simple and reliable.